So here we are in the East Village with Billy the Artist, who I'm actually happy to say I'm meeting for the first time. So Billy, what a pleasure to meet you.
It's so great to meet you too, and I'm happy you are here in my beautiful studio in the East Village.
Tell us about some other influences, perhaps here in New York, kind of coming up in the art world, and also friends, contemporaries right now who sort of find their way in.
Well, I started as a street artist 25 years ago here in the East Village, selling my artwork on the streets, doing murals on the streets.
Selling the artwork on the street all over the place, specific places?
You know what, back in the early 90s, there were tons of artists selling artwork in Soho. Soho actually was the place to sell your art in the street. I also did here in the East Village, but it was mainly in Soho. But I think, as far as influences go, one person once said to me that if Picasso, Keith Haring, and Peter Max, if they all got together at the end of the day and they had some drinks and got a little loopy, you'd have Billy the Artist.
Yeah, that's amazing.
That's amazing, and I love that idea. I love that visual. So why don't we take a tour inside and see this beautiful apartment? We have the afternoon light making its way in. Let's go. After you.
Yeah, let's go. Come on in. This is the main studio. It's a nice enough space to live and work in. Usually when I do like larger projects, it's always usually site specific, but I've been here 25 years and I absolutely love it. And I've kind of made it like, if you see everything's painted, it's just like, you know, when you come in here, you get to know who I am. You know, I don't really consider myself a street artist. I just consider myself an artist, you know? Although what's so great about street art is, even right now, I've recently done maybe four or five different murals here in the city. I did a huge one, like about 150 feet by 30 feet, up Bruckner Boulevard at the building of Zero's Bakery, which is a very well-known bakery. So that was a fantastic project. There was another one called 100 Gates, which they do on the Lower East Side, where they're taking like the gates of businesses and they're having artists, you know, paint on them.
Who's spearheading that initiative?
It's the Lower East Side organization, the people who are in charge of that.
Like the community board,
it's
or something?
Lower East Side, you know, I should probably know the organization. I know the woman, Natalie. But it's an amazing project. And I have a huge one on Delancey and Orchard. And again, it's just, you know, making, you know, the neighborhood more beautiful, more lively. And again, the great thing about street art is, you know, not many people get to see your artwork in a gallery sometimes.
Right.
Street art, thousands and thousands of people get to see it every single day.
Tell me how you sort of navigate working with brands and sort of maintaining this artistic integrity. Does that weigh on you at all?
No,
or is this
no.
A new world? I mean, I believe
it's
sort of
changed so much. You know, even since I started, you know, I've been making a living for 25 years. It has changed so much. Because I think the idea is, you know, I've always want people to see who I am through my art, you know? And especially nowadays with social media, the more ways you can get your vision and your art to people, I think the better. So, you know, why not put your artwork on something that is useful, something you can use, something you can wear. Like this is, you know, I did it for Nescafe, you know? And so, yeah, it's a funky, cool little coffee machine. And also, too, you know, it makes like a beautiful piece of art in your house. And I think that's what it is now, is that you can have, you know, your artwork on a product, but that's a piece of art. I did this thing for Mountain Dew, right? There was limited edition Mountain Dew bottles. It was myself and like a bunch of other artists. Limited edition. Some were tattoo artists, some were graffiti artists, some were, you know, fine artists, pop artists. And, you know, the idea of it is, you know, okay, someone could drink out of it, the bottle, but then again, then they keep it and they put it on their mantle and it's, you know, a beautiful piece of art. Tokyo.
Let me tell you,
pretty cool.
What did you ask Santa Claus for Christmas this year?
I just want to continue to be able to make my living as an artist. Santa, please. Make me continue to make a great living and a life as an artist. Be happy, be healthy, my family and friends be healthy, and let's just celebrate life together.
Well, that's pretty beautiful. Well, Billy the Artist, thank you so much, and it was such a pleasure to meet you, and thank you for welcoming us into your home. It's beautiful.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
All right, man.
Pleasure.
Better on the piano.
Thank you.